Well, welcome back to the fencing venue here at the University Sports Hall in Salerno, all part of the Napoli 2019 Summer Universiad, the 30th edition of this competition. And fencing has been there right from the very start in Turin in 1959. And it's time to introduce the athletes and the referees in this gold medal match. It's a matchup between Italy and Russia. And it's 3 minutes of fencing, or the first fencer to reach the target score of five. He's going to make a move, and does, and Foyetta sees it coming. The fencing is so much about footwork. You've got to close the distance close enough. If you attack from too far out, so 10 seconds left on the clock. I think that they will settle. And referee calls halt, and the score sits at 3-0.
Anga, break, Ali.
Oh, this is a good leg for Martinyuk. Well, all the good work that was done in leg one for Italy has been undone. And Daria Martinyuk scoring 10 there to bring the score to 10-5. So a really good leg two for the Russian, and Evgenia Zarkov is coming on. Zarkova is coming on for Russia, and she'll be up against Roberta Manzani. Manzani clear, single light there. Brings up a cheer from the Italian crowd. Another single light. A little bit of catch up. Four apiece in leg three. Manzani getting one just in the last few seconds. And a good leg for the Italian there. And we're going to bring back fencers that have already fenced. Maria Obratsova comes on for Russia, and Eleonora DiMarchi comes on for Italy. Oh. Oh, Demarchi getting in there, not getting hit. Able to avoid the point of the Russian's Epée. So just 3 points in it. Italy are by no means out of this. Another old one for the Italians. With Team Epée, it's all about staying in touch. Don't need to reach the target scores, just need to stay in touch with your opponents. And it's a slow burner, but it will come to the boil as we go into the latter stages. So 15-13, Russia still have the lead, but their lead has been whittled to just 2 points. Well, you've got to say the Russian is exciting to watch.
Aga, Preet, Ali. Alt, Kudu.
Another double. Now we are getting close to the target score.
Aga, Preet, Ali.
One more for the Russian would see us through. Italy. 24-23. Only a few seconds left on the clock. Will they step away? I don't think that Sharkova is going to want to hand over with the scores level. So she is backing away. And the scores are 24-23. So Italy in the lead for the first time since leg one. Double scored. The defensive really wants to commit too much, take too many risks with the scoreboard so close as it is. And Marzani, who's being edged towards her back line, decided she needed to attack, but the longer reach of Martinho was able to gain her the point. So it's level again at 26 apiece. 30 the target, but I'm not sure if they're going to make it with the fencing that they're doing in this leg. The lead's so important in Epée. No one wants to give it up. I reckon we'll have a... got time for another attack. Who's going to be brave enough? Oh, and it was Marzani that went on the attack, but Martinyuk who came away with the point. It was almost a fake attack by the Russian that started Marzani off. Second intention from the Russian, trying to draw the attack of Marzani. And the Italian immediately responding. Lovely disengage there. Fate one way, underneath circular disengage. Mazzani looking to control the blade on the way through of the taller Russian fencer. And once she got a hold of it, she was able to come and launch the attack, knowing that she can safely do that without being hit herself. So 10 seconds left on the clock. Italy have a slender lead. They are likely to step away. And they do, and the score sits at 28-27. Italy back in the lead, albeit by only 1 point since leg one. So we're into the final third of this match, and coming on for Russia, it is the teenager Yevgenia Sharkova. And she is coming on with a minus two indicator. So she's given away two more points than she's scored. And she is up against Eleonora DeMarchi, who's on a minus six indicator. Most of that down to that second leg where Daria Martinyuk beat her 10-2. So Sharkova, two quick points, has got the Russians back in the lead. Well, so 30-29, make that that's another double. We do see a lot of doubles with Sharkova. The target for this leg is 35. Sharkova is fencing brilliantly here. She fenced really well in the individual competition. A little bit naive in the final, just to keep on attacking when she had that 2 point deficit and gave away so many doubles that just ran out of space on the scoreboard. But doubles now will favor the Russian. Another double. She's very fast on the attack. Closes the distance well with good footwork. Attacking with her arm back and then can really extend. Oh, missed that time. DeMarchi came with the attack and Sharkova couldn't land, a little bit too slow. So just a 1 point lead. Oh, good body evasion there from Sharkova. So the Russian just 1 point away. And she gets it. So 35-32. The Russians are back in the lead. Bratsov is not going to take any risks, not with a 1 point lead. And Mazzani had to attack there. And that time the parry was good from the Russian and opened up that space to come through with the riposte and hit with a single light. So 37-35, 40 is the target score. This is the penultimate leg. And the Russians will be hoping to go into that final leg with a couple of points lead. Right on the back line. The double. Well, that only really favours the Russians right now. So two more points needed to reach that target score of 40 for Russia, but I don't think that Abratsova is really going to risk anything to score those points. She's just going to invite Marzani on. Wait for the Italian to attack and try and hit on the counter or double out. And she does double out on that one, 39-37. Fine margins in Epée. Marzani needs a single light on. Ah, and it's a single light to the Russians. So 40-37. It's a three-point deficit. It's not impossible to get that back, but it's going to be a difficult job for Nicole Foietta, who comes on for Italy. So that last match, leg eight, was five apiece. So Marzani finishes on a plus three indicator. So good fencing from her. And Maria Abratsova finishes on a minus five.
Break.
Interesting. So Daria Martinyuk against Nicole Foietta, the Italian with work to do, but time on the clock, but not much room on the scoreboard, so has to be wary of doubles. Needs to get this first single light on. So Foietta, can she do it? Can she work out a way of getting through without getting hit? No, it's a double. Now, we said earlier in this gold medal match that doubles didn't matter early on. Well, they do now. And every double that's scored will be cheered on by the Russians. The Russian bench there, they've done their job. Don't expect the Russian to attack. She's going to watch and wait and see what Nicole Foietta does. They've come together, core to core, body to body. Referee calls halt. Now they reset where they are on the piste, which will be advantage Foietta. Martinyuk just backed right onto the back line. Single light for the Russian. Just caught her on the wrist. Now things are looking bleak for Italy. Martinyuk might take a risk and attack now that she's got that four-point cushion. Just keeping Foietta honest not backing off too quickly, but Foyet is doing the pressing. She's pressing, trying to drive the Russian to the back line. Oh, nice one. Foyeta just landed on target on the leg of the Russian. Just before they came, Cora Court. Double. And Russia are just within two now. So the Russian team can barely watch. Foyeta pressing forward. Needs to get on the initiative. And another one for the Russians. Just one away from taking this gold medal. 4-point lead. And the defense from Martinyuk has been outstanding in this final leg. And she's done it. The Russians have won gold. Well, the lead changed hands a couple of times throughout that match, but it swung really decisively to the Russians in, it was leg seven that really made the difference. That was where the match was won for Team Russia, and confirmation that they are the winners. Confirmation, Russia in gold, Italy in silver, and Poland in bronze.